morning to all of you. Now we are going to check the content provider. Now content provider is same as the database. So by using a SQLite database, we are going to add or we are going to insert, update it and display the records by using a content provider. Now first what we have done, we have taken the layout. Now we are going to check what the layout is. So click on the activity layout. Here we have taken a name and a grade, and when you click on the add name, it is going to add the names. When you click on the retrieve student, it is going to display the student list. So this was a very simple application. Just we have taken two text box and two button. So when you see the XML code, this is the text view, this is the image button, again one button and two text boxes and the button. So we have taken three text boxes and two buttons. Now we have called the button add, that is find view by id, r.id.button. So here the typecasting should be done. Now when you click on add name, so this is the method we have to write. Now, when you click on add name, we have to use the content values for adding a record. So content values value is equal to new content values. Now values dot put, we have to put in a student provider dot name. Now student provider is what? Student provider is again a content provider. So when you click on the student provider, you will get this provider. So the class is student provider, it should extend a content provider. Now this is going to use the classes of the SQLite. Already we have seen how to add, update and delete data in the SQLite database. This is same by using the Now we are created class student provider. So you have to create a class student provider, and it should extend content provider. After that we have to create some constants. So public final string provider name, you have to give a provider name. So provider name should be com.example.myapplication.studentProvider. So this is the location, or this is the exact location of the class. The class name is student provider, so this is class name student provider, same as this one. So this is the class name, and this is the package com.example.myapplication. So you can check the package over here, com.example.myapplication. So first thing, we have to give the provider name. So provider name should be complete with the package. After that we have to give the URL. URL is content:// provider name. So provider name is over here /students. So this will be a table. Now we need column, that is _ID, name and grade. We have created one hash map, and here we have created students as 1 and student ID is 2. Now final string URI match. Now URI matcher should be like this. URI matcher is equal to new URI matcher dot no match. URI matcher dot add URL. Add URL for the student and add URL for the student ID. Now these are again the static values. After that we have to give a particular database. Now private SQLite database DB. So in the previous example also we have created the object of a SQLite database. The database name should be a college and the table name should be students. So we have to provide constant strings. After that static final integer database version is 1. Static final string create db table. So we have to create a database. Now create table, table name, and these are the column name and these are the values or the parameters. So id, it should be in the integer, primary key auto increment, name should be text and grade should be text. So like this we have to first create a table. After that we have called private static class database helper, and it should extend a class SQLite open helper. Now we have written the constructor database helper is context, and we have called super, that is base class method. Now public void onCreate method. OnCreate method, we have to execute a query db.executeSQL create db table. So here is the create db table. We have called this string. OnUpgrade, what we have to do? We have to drop the table if it exists and where to create a table. So already if it is a table, then where to drop it and where to create the new table if it does not exist. Next method is onCreate. So context object is context is going to get context. Database helper db helper is equal to new database helper. So we have created the object of the class. Now here we have used ternary operator. We have called get writable database, get readable database, and get writable database. These are the two methods we have seen previously. Now if db is null, then return false, otherwise it will return true. A public URI insert, return type is URI. We have to insert at a particular values a particular URI, that means at this URI we have to give the values. db.insert student table name and the values. If the row ID is greater than 0, then URI underscore URI is equal to content URIs with append IDs, content URIs and row ID. Now get context resolver, notify change underscore URI, and this is null. And the URI we want to return it. Now throw an new SQL exception, fail to add a record into. If there is an error, it is going to give the exception. Suppose I want to retrieve the values, then the code will be like this. Public output is a cursor, query is equal to, the values we are passing is URI and string type of values, projection, string selection arguments, and string sort order. SQLite query builder, that is db is equal to new SQLite query builder. db.setTables, student table name. We have to use switch case, URI matcher.matchURI, case student and case student ID. db.projectionMap, student projection map. db.appendWhere, means once the record is added, we have to append other records one by one. It is again if else condition. If it is null, then we have to sort the order by ascending or descending or by default. So by default, sort on student names. Now cursor c is equal to db.query, db projection and selection, and selection arguments group by null, having null sort order by using sort order. That means by using name we want to sort the values. Now c.setNotificationURI, get context.getResolver and URI and return c. That means from this code you can understand that we want to return the records, because records are stored in a cursor, and in a cursor it is a temporary storage of the records. Now suppose I want to delete any record. Now this will be code for the deletion of the record. Now here we want to give the table name, we want to give the selection, we want to give the selection arguments. Now the query will be student table, that is table name, where id is equal to, we are giving id as input, and we want to check if it is empty or not by using text utils. If it is empty, we want to give the exception. In the similar fashion, this is for the update. This is for the getting the type. Now this is what the code for the content provider. Content provider means it is going to insert, update or delete records in a database. Now this, the content provider entry should be there in the Android manifest. So if you check Android manifest, here should be the entry. So Android name is student provider, class name, and the authorities are entire sequence or entire package name com.example.myapplication.studentProvider. So like this we want to give the entry in the Android manifest. Now this is student provider. Now we want to get all these providers into content provider. Now on click add name, content values is equal to new content values.put student provider.name. Now edit text find view by id r.add.edtText2.getText. It means from the text boxes we want to add the values, that is name, grade, we want to add. I am calling insert method. Now by using student provider.uri dot values, comma values. So by using this we are going to add the values. Now we want to retrieve the records. So first we want to give the URL. What is the URL? That is content:com.example.myapplication.studentprovider. URI student is equal to URI.parseURL, and cursor C is equal to managed query students, and this all are null, and we want sort by name. Now here this is deprecated. That means in the previous version it was allowed, but in the later versions it is not allowed. So managed query, that was deprecated function. Now C to move to the first, do toast make test. That means this is for the toast message if we want to give the values. So this was the code for the content provider. Now you can run the code and you can check the output. What will be the output? Of course, this code is stored in the SQLite database. In the last lecture also, we have seen how we are going to use SQLite database, and in the content provider also we are using SQLite database. Content provider is nothing but it is another way to store data by using SQLite. So this was the end of the session. If you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.